Hi, I'm Todd Cross, and Ph.D. candidate here at the Rocky Mountain Research Station and at the University of Montana, and I work in the Wildlife Genetics Lab. We're taking an unprecedentedly fine resolution approach to population genetics study with greater sage-grouse. We know there are birds across the landscape, but we don't really know where they move and breed. We just kind of have an idea of where they are. And so what we've done is we've gotten samples from just a huge number of the leks across the landscape. And the leks are these spring breeding grounds. So the birds kind of congregate there in spring, the males display, and the females choose a mate. And so what that does is if we're capturing birds at that point, we're getting kind of their lockdown at that location every spring. And so we get feathers from the birds at that point, and we extract the DNA from the tip of the feather, so we don't even have to handle the birds. And from that, we can identify down to an individual. And so then once we have individuals identified, we also have genetic information that tells us about relatedness. We're using this network theory or graph theory. So the idea is to use the genetic information to construct a network of relatedness. And so we can say, all right, between these two leks are this related. And then bring a third one in, how related are they? What's the interrelatedness between those three? And we're at this point, we've run these analyses with somewhere around 380 leks. You can take those analyses anywhere from at the lek and figure out what birds are there, how related are they. But then we can blow that up to a much more massive scale where we're involved with some range-wide research now. So 11 western states where the bird is currently distributed. And we're using some really cool approaches to try to prioritize sage-grouse populations for management so that when managers need to make a decision about where to put conservation dollars on the landscape, they can point to some particular locations and say, all right, this is where we're going to invest our resources. Preserving the intact habitat that exists, this sagebrush landscape, influences so many species from mule deer to pygmy rabbits, and then just countless passerine birds that require intact sagebrush landscape. And so really, they're just kind of, people would call them an umbrella species, or even just, they're like the canary in the coal mine for sagebrush and intact sagebrush habitats. So our work in conserving sage-grouse will actually pay dividends in actually preserving this landscape for future generations to be able to go out and recreate and see these processes that have been going on for millennia.